11 of the Ghana Premier League is here with us, and boy, was match day 10 exciting, especially with the big game between Kumasi Asante Kotoko, who managed to get a fortuitous victory over Accra Hearts of Oak on Monday at the Accra Sports Stadium. Now, the first round is getting close to an end, and the league is getting even closer. Now, let's look at the first fixture, and it's Ediana Stars, who beat Liberty Professionals away in Dansumon by 3-2 in a very, very good performance, welcoming Dreams FC. Now, Dreams managed to get back on the winning track last weekend after losing 2 league games, but Doma is always a hard place to visit for any teams, especially with the form that Yahya Mohammed is carrying at the moment. 6 goals in his last 3 games. I think that this will be a bit too hard for Dreams FC. They are going to lose this game in Doma. Kumasi Asante Kotoko will return to their favourite Baba Nyara Stadium, where they will welcome Ebusu Adwas, who are not faring too well. Kotoko will be carrying some confidence after that great victory over Accra Hearts of Oak. Dauda Mohammed looking really, really good. The young chap seems to be one for the future. Evans Kwao also played really well in Accra when he got a chance in the team. I have a feeling though that he will return to the bench because Richard Osei-Ajimai will be back to partner Ahmed Adams. On the whole, I think that Kumasi Asante Kotoko will be far too strong for Ebusu Adwas. Now, this is normally a traditional clash between two of the most famous sides in Ghana, but Ebusu Adwas over the past few years, yes, that is where they have been. So Kumasi Asante Kotoko, favourites to win this one for me. Now, Germany has FC Hollywood, that is Bayern Munich. Ghana has Obuasi Ashgold. So much drama around the defending champions. They are putting up one of the worst title defenses I have seen. Eric Opoku, who was league MVP, I disagreed with that, so let me put it on public record, seems to be having a really, really poor season. And Bashir Herford just does not seem to know what to do to get the best out of his team. This is a good opportunity to get a win with Bechim United, one of the poorest travellers in the league, visiting them. But the thing is this, Bechim United beat Wah All-Stars in their last league fixture by 2-0. Wah All-Stars are top of the league, so definitely means Bechim United are improving. Ashgold should be careful. I wish I could say though they would lose this game. I think that they will draw this game at the Linkley Sports Stadium. Match of the week definitely will be in Brekum, where Chelsea, the best home record, they've played 5 games, scored 8 goals. Sadiq Adams has been absolutely brilliant there. We'll welcome Accra Hearts of Oak, best away record in the league, 11 points out of a possible 15, unbeaten. Kenichi has conquered all the hard places. They said that then he went there and he got some points. Can he conquer Brekum? I think not. I think that Sadiq Adams and his team will be far too strong for Accra Hearts of Oak, and they'll lose 2 on the trot. Why? I think that the team has hit its peak. I think that the players are not going to score. I think that at the moment, Kenichi has too much drama on the side with this banter between himself and the management going on. Accra Hearts of Oak, be careful before you ruin what is turning out to be a good season. Brekum Chelsea wins this one. In second D, 2 of the poorest league sides this season will meet. Second D, Hazakes taking on Nio Dubiase. I must admit, Nio Dubiase have shown signs of improvement in the past 2 weeks or so, especially after that morale-boosting victory over Kumasi Asante Kotoko. Second D, Hazakes lost at home the last time they were there to Liberty Professionals, and we hope to get back on track. Look, the way I look at this game, both sides deserve a point. Draw it is for me. The northern part of the Borno Ahafo region will see fireworks because Techiman will welcome league leaders Wild All-Stars to the den. Now, Techiman City have proved to be one of the unpredictable teams in the league this season, especially at home, unbeaten, but they failed to beat Accra Hearts of Oak. Wild All-Stars have also proven that they can win games away and at home. Remember, they beat Ediana Stars away in Doma. I have a feeling though that Techiman City will have slightly too much in the bag for Wild All-Stars, who will lose their second game on the trot. I think that their reign atop of the Ghana Premier League will come to an end on match day 11. For me, Techiman City, Mickey Charles, carries all 3 points at the den. Final game of match day 11 preview. Tema Inter Allies, a team dire in need of points, will be visiting Wafa, a team who are very strong at home but are proving to be very inconsistent this season. Two teams who play really nice football, and both of them are used to playing on an AstroTurf. I think that this game will favour Wafa because they have slightly better confidence at the moment. Inter Allies are playing so well, but things do not seem to be going well for them in front of goal. Wafa wins this game narrowly, 1-0. That ends the preview for match day 11. And for more information, you can visit www.pulse.com.gh for more information. Or you can check out our Facebook page. Look, we have live tickets going on. We have videos. We have photos. Everything is happening. Enjoy match day 11.